Number 5. Recycling shows from other networks.
Cartoon Network has pulled several shows off of other networks in order to capitalize on their publicity and for people who want to see them, but for some reason did not get the network that originally showed them. The shows that are most often targeted are shows from the WB Network or ABC Family.
Totally Spies, Jackie Chan Adventures, Shaolin Showdown, and many other non-original shows were sucked up by the bloodthirsty amoeba that is Cartoon Network. And that's not all. The Canadian network Teletoon also recently had several shows blatantly stolen from it, including that god-awful show Total Drama Island.
Look, if I wanted to watch a reality show starring fictional characters, I'd watch Lucky Star. At least that show had more interesting characters and didn't make me feel like I was watching a bad Survivor episode animated by the creators of South Park, which, by the way, are both shows I can't stand. But wait! There's more!
As if this weren't enough, Cartoon Network actually had the nerve to cut off Shaolin Showdown before it could ever finish.
Oh wait, the WB did that too. Seriously, and right at the beginning of a new season too. Sound familiar? And speaking of Teen Titans, let's move on to number 4.
Number 4. Prematurely canceling shows.
Now, I've been mentioning this number all through this countdown, but I'm going to sum it all up here. Teen Titans, Shaolin Showdown, Stormhawks, and so many other even better shows that I couldn't even begin to name them all, were all taken from us before their time. And you know what? That's pretty much all I've got to say, except to quote myself, Cartoon Network, if people like to watch a show, then don't fucking cancel it! Do you have any common sense? I think I just answered my own question.
Number 3. The Early Morning Dumps.
No, it's not a horrible bowel condition, even though this term definitely deals with massive amounts of crap. You see, Cartoon Network's habit of prematurely canceling shows is often a self-fulfilling prophecy, because they stick them in terrible time slots where they'll never be watched.
For example, why did a show with such a ridiculous concept as the Hi Hi Puffy Yummy Yumi Show last so long?
Good marketing and a good time slot. It was on Friday night when every kid got the chance to see it. And to be honest, even though it had fuck all to do with the original artist it was based on, it was actually a pretty entertaining show. But when Cartoon Network thought that the show was getting low ratings, guess what they decided to do? Not move it to a better time slot so it would get better ratings, or give it more time to gel with the audience. No. Instead, they proved their ill logic even further by moving shows that could have gotten better ratings, like Megas XLR and freaking Yu Yu Hakusho, to sometime between the hours of 3 and 5 in the morning. Newsflash, Cartoon Network, nobody gets up that early!
When you saw that a show that you liked had been moved to that time slot, you knew in the back of your mind that that was the beginning of the end. The show would never continue to run after this. Number 2. The cancellation of Toonami.
Someone on my profile page, a user by the name of Kassam Alimali, I believe, wanted me to do a rant on this subject, and I think that this part will suffice. For those of you who don't know, Toonami was a kick-ass block on Cartoon Network on Saturday nights, and it certainly fared better than the crap-tastic Fried Dynamite block in my book. It usually had more action-packed shows than shows that were for older kids, but not technically mature enough to be on Adult Swim. Like I said, it kicked ass. It was what had most of the anime on it, and despite the fact that it was dubbed pretty badly in retrospect, Rave Master was one of the ones that I looked forward to the most. Which is why it went right the fuck out of left field and drove straight off a cliff that led straight to the depths of hell when Cartoon Network decided to cancel it. How do you even begin to think that that was a good idea?
I didn't know back then, and frankly, I still don't know.
It's a stupid, foolish idea to cancel a series that had a lot going for it just because of poor ratings. If I can make a suggestion, maybe it was due to all the character changes.
Now, the first host of Toonami, the CGI animated Tom, looked like Rayman, but the second version was much cooler. However, later on, the robots in the show started looking like Meguzi rejects.
But that's probably not the reason why it was canceled. But I couldn't begin to tell you the reason for it, because I still don't have a clue why. And that's pretty much all I've got to say on the subject. Kassam Alimali, there's your rant. I hope you enjoyed it. Because now it's time to bring this list to a close.
And the number one worst moment of Cartoon Network was every single goddamn show in CN Real.
I mean, Cartoon Network has fucked up royally in the past, and we all know it has. But when the shitty movie Reanimated came out, I knew we were in for trouble.
Because sure enough, we got the shitty live-action show out of Jimmy's head out of it.
You know, I hate to quote an age-old argument, but why put a live-action show on a network called freaking Cartoon Network? Oh, but it got worse. And considering how bad Reanimated was, that's pretty bad. Another person suggested that I do a rant on a show called Survive This, and after seeing it, I'm convinced this is by far the cruelest TV show I've ever seen.
Tricking kids into going to a camp that's never existed, and then putting them in life or death situations is not good television.
I mean, putting this on Discovery Kids would probably have worked, but CN, what the hell were they thinking? Oh, and by the way, I think the title of this next show sums up the entire creative process of making this block.
The final show that I'm going to discuss is called Dude, What Would Happen?
Now doesn't that sort of bring this image to mind? Dude, what would happen if we put a live-action block on a network with Cartoon in the title? I bet that would make everyone totally not hate us again. I need scissors. 61!
Anyway, Dude, What Would Happen is essentially a Mythbusters ripoff for kids.
And all things considered, I'd rather watch Mythbusters any day. And there are even more pointless shows such as Destroy, Build, Destroy. But I won't go into that because it's at this point that I just stopped caring. And once and for all, stopped watching Cartoon Network altogether. In conclusion, I stopped watching TV about the time I started going to college. Because it's at this point that I realized just how crappy the shows on TV really were, and decided that one less person would be a mindless TV zombie and give them more ratings. And ultimately, this is the solution to all of our problems. I'm Shinobi Flair saying, if you don't like it, change the channel. And if nothing's good on, just turn the damn thing off.